So class, in lecture 2, we discussed about the spring derivation, closed coil helical spring derivation we did it, and we find out the some formulas. That formula already we written here, that where we find out the torque, the torque is having a W into R, and we find out the shear stress formula, and we find out the delta D deflection, and K is the stiffness of the spring, and the theta is the angle of twist. So on the basis of these formulas, on the basis of our previous lecture derivation, we will discuss some conceptual questions of your springs. So let's start with the first question. The first question you already written on your board. You can see a closed coil helical spring is to carry a load of 1000 newton. It means what is given to you? First one is given to you a load axial load W of 1000 newton is given to you. Second one thing, its mean coil diameter is to be 10 times that the wire diameter. Then calculate this diameter. Just I'm plotting a spring, then I will remember that what is the mean diameter and what is the diameter of the, and we will put the all these value that you are having in your question. So this is your center line, this is your center line that passing through. From the center line your load W is working, kitna diya aapko 1000 newton. Is it clear? And it's a mean diameter. Coil diameter is to be a 10 times of the wire diameter. If you suppose, let us, I am taking this shaded diameter d, small d, and he is saying that the mean diameter of the coil, it means this one, from the center line it is your 10d, and where small d is the diameter of the wire. So let given terms means a coil diameter, capital D is your 10 times of D is given to you, 10 times, and the wire diameter, and the wire diameter is taken as small d in your figure also. So calculate the dia. If the maximum shear stress in the material of the spring is to be 100 mega newton per meter, it means tau shear stress, it means this value is given to you, a tau is equal to 100 mega newton per meter square. Is it clear? So from this shear stress formula we have to W. In the shear stress formula is given to you tau is equal to 16WR divided by the pi d cube. Is it clear? What is the mean diameter? Mean diameter we can find it here. It's a 10d divided by 2. It means 5d. So tau value you having? You have a tau value as it is given to you. So we will equate 100 here is equal to, it's a mega newton. It means you convert into newton, 10 raised to power 6 is equal to 16 into W. What is the W is given to you? 1000 newton, and R is the 10d by 2. So 10d by 2, it means 5d divided by pi d cube. When we solve this, we will find out the in terms of d. What will be the d? We will can find out easily d here. D square 16 into 1000 into 5 divided by 100 into 10 raised to power 6. So when we solve this, when I am solving this, it will be a d square 8800 divided by the 10 raised to power 6. Second term is the pi is also there. So further I am solving this, d square 8 divided by 10 raised to power 4 into 3.14. D care will obtain 0.0025. This is 50 mm, where D, small d diameter, I am obtaining here from the calculation, it's a 50 mm. Second one thing is there, if this even is there, so we easily identified the this value. We can easily identify the this value, how it could be a capital D is equal to 10 into 50. 50 was the diameter of the wire. So D is equal to 500 mm is the mean diameter of the coil. It means the mean diameter, mean diameter 10D was this. It was not a diameter. This is your diameter from center to center. This was the diameter 10D. So it will become a 5D. If I am taking a single one, it will be taking radius, so it will be a 5D. So radius of the mean coil is 250 mm. Is it your answer? And this is your answer. Is it clear? So next question, a helical spring is made of the 10 mm diameter. It means what is given to you? A helical spring is made of the 10 mm diameter. It means a D, this D is given to you 10. Or you can say 0.01 meter. Is it clear? Next one thing, wound on a 100 mm diameter mandrel. It means wounded on a mandrel. Mandrel diameter, capital D, is given to you 100 mm, or you can say 0.1 meter. Is it clear? Next one, we have to find out the stiffness of the spring. You can say spring constant. Constant K you have to identify. Okay, you have to take your modulus of rigidity C. You can take here 100 giganewton, it means 10 raised to 9 newton per meter square. I are directly converted into the newton meter to easy out calculation. What force must be applied to the spring to elongate it by the 50? It means your delta is the deflection of 50 mm is given to you, and this delta 50 mm is deflected when your load is applied. And what load is applied, we have to find out. And delta having a relation, stiffness K is equal to W by delta. So delta is your 64 WR cube N divided by CD cube. Is it clear? So it means we have to identify W. So we have a two relations. So stiffness constant K W upon 64 W R cube N divided by CD key 4, W is cancelled out. So the W will be cancelled out. From here, we can have all these values. We have to find out K. We have R, we have a value, mean diameter 100 divided by 2. And we diameter of the coil is also given, while we also given to you. So we both the two terms are given. And N, N is the number of turns. Your N number of turns is given to you in your question. Yes, there are 10 active coils. It means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. It's N active turns are there. It means your N is given to you 10. So we can find from putting these values, or C. What is your C here? 100 into 10 raised to power 9. 100 into 10 raised to power 9 multiply by D key 4. What do you mean by D? Small d. Small d diameter, it means 0.01. It means 0.01 cup 4 divided by 64 R cube. What will be R? Diameter of the capital D. Capital D. So 0.1 divided by 2 raised to power 3. And N is the number of turns. We further solve it. A K 10 raised to power 11 into 1, 10 raised to power 4 divided by 100 hoga, so it means 10 raised to power minus 8. Further, 64 into 0.1 है, 1 by 2 root of 3, 8, 10 raised to power, 1 by 10 हो जाएगा, तो 10 raised to power -3 मल्टीप्लाई बाय, व्हेन आई विल सॉल्व दिस, -5, 8, 8, 10, सो 10 raised to power 5 डिवाइड बाय 8, अ के विल आइडेंटिफाइड एज अ 1, 2, 5, आई थिंक 0, 0, व्हाट विल बी द यूनिट्स, W by delta, W is the Newton and delta in meter. So 1, 2, 5, 0, 0 Newton per meter, we identified the K is the spring constant. K is equal to W upon delta, where K you identified here, or you can say W is equal to K multiplied by delta, or you can say W is equal to K 1, 2, 5, 0, 0 multiply by delta your 50. So what will be the value? Is it clear? So divide by 1000. So you will get the value of W. So in your question, you have to find out the constant spring constant K. Your K spring constant value is V. Obtained here, and from to displace your spring at a 50 mm, so you need to apply a load, and applied load is 625 newton, when the deflection will get the 50 mm. So this is the question. So in third question, a helical coil spring is made of round steel wire, diameter given to you is 10 mm, or it can be a 0.01 meter. Is it clear? Next one is, a mean radius of the helix is 20 mm. A mean radius of helix, it means mean radius R is given to you 20 mm, or you can say 0.02 meter. Next thing, the number of active turns. So number of turns, N is given to you 10. The spring is closely coiled. If the C, it means spring is closely coiled. So it means our load is exerted from the top side, and it will be in a close position. So if C modulus of rigidity given to you 100 giganewton per meter square, find pull required to extend the spring by 20. Similarly, previously we also identified that when the deflection delta is given to you 50, and you have to find out the applied load. Similarly, we have to find out the pull required to, it means W you have to find out when your delta deflection is given to you at 20 mm, or you can say 0.02 meter. Next is your stress. Tau is need to identify. It means your W load you have to identify, and you have to tau to identify. So you know that if your deflection delta is given to you, you know the from the formula a delta, when a derivation we derive the derivation, when we identify that the a delta is equal to 64 WR cube N divided by CD cube. Is it clear? Your W you have to identify. And your delta is given to you, and your R is given to you, and N is also given to you, and C is also given to you, and D, diameter of the wire, is given to you. You can easily identify that it means delta is equal to 64 W into R. What would be a R? R is the mean radius, is 0.02 cube, and N is active number of turns, is given to you 10. Active number of turn is given to you 10. And what is your C? C is given to you 100 giganewton. It means we convert it into Newton, 10 raised to power 9 multiplied DQ4. What is diameter given to you? Diameter 0.01 meter raised to power 4. And delta is also given to you. So delta is, I am putting delta. Delta is also given to you 0.02. 0.02. Further, we can solve this question. W is here and I'm taking this side, all term. 2 is to 10 raised to power minus 2, I can write this. 9 and 2, 11, 10 raised to power 11. 1 divided by 100, and raised to power 4, it means 10 raised to power minus of 2 to 4, 4 and 8. 10 raised to power 8, now this term is in denominator. 64 multiply by 2 raised to power 3, it means 8. 1 by 100, it means 10 raised to power minus 6 into 10 raised to power, 10 is equal to W. You can identify that, how it could be identified that. This one cancel out. Only 10 is left here. And from 10 to 10, this is also cancel out. And this 10 raised to power 6 is going to upper side. And 2 to the 4, it will be cancel out. So you can see W is equal to 10 raised to power 6 divided by 256. We will identify that 3906 Newton. Is it clear? So W you identified that 3906 when you solve this. Now in the question you need to find out the tau at shear stress. You know the shear stress formula. Tau is equal to what is the tau? 16 WR divided by pi d cube. Your W and identified, you can put this value W, and R is already known to you, and your D is also known to you, and we can equate and just put these values 16 into 3906 into R. What should be R? R 0.02. 0.02 3.14 into D cube. What is the D? R D is 0.01 raised to power cube. Further, I am solving this. If I am solve this, to further minimize the terms, 16 into 3906 into 2 raised to power 10 raised to minus 2, 3.14 into 1 into 10 raised to power minus 6, minus 4. You can say 3, approximate, I am taking approximate here, 5, 10, this is 10, and this is minus 3 again. So, the tau shear stress, when you calculate the shear stress, it will be here. It will be concluded as 402 mega Newton per meter square. So this is your shear stress value. You will identify your tau shear stress, and we identified that the W is the axial load on the spring. So your next question number 4, you can see a closed coil helical spring has mean diameter 100 mm. It means a helical spring having a mean diameter 100 mm and the spring constant K of 100 kN per meter. So it has a 10 number of coils. What is the suitable diameter of spring wire diameter? We have to find out the dia of the wire, and you have given a mean diameter. Capital D is given to you 100 mm, or you can say 0.1 meter is given to you. Spring constant K is also given to you. This is your 100 kN per meter. Similarly, N number of coils, active 10 coils is also given to you, and modulus of rigidity C spring is also given to you, it's 100 giga Newton per meter square. What is the maximum axial load spring can carry? It means we need to find out a W and D. From the derivation, we concluded that where T is torque during the loading condition with respect to mean diameter R, your torque should be represented by T is equal to W into R. From the torsion equation, your T by IP is equal to what should be here in terms of tau shear stress by R. Or further, I am solving this. I can see a T is equal to tau into IP divided by R. So your tau is given to you. If the maximum shear stress is node X to 200 MN, it means a tau is also given to you. Tau maximum shear stress is 200 MN per meter square is given to you. Now from these two equation we can identify W into R is equal to tau IP divided by R. Is it clear? I'm putting the values here. We have to find out the W. So W is added to W, and R is the डी इज द डायमीटर गिवन टू यू, इट मीन 0.1 मीटर डिवाइड बाय 2 इज गिवन टू यू. इज इट क्लियर? नेक्स्ट वन टाउ. शियर स्ट्रेस इज आल्सो गिवन टू यू 200 मेगा न्यूटन, इट मीन 10 to the power 6. एंड पोलर मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया आई पी फॉर अ सर्कुलर सेक्शन, इट विल बी रिप्रेजेंट एज पाई, हाउ कुड बी ए पाई डी की 4 डिवाइड बाय 32 और डिवाइड बाय आर. एंड आर शुड बी वी कैन राइट आर इज डी बाई 2. सो दिस इज 16, डी 2 टू कैंसिल आउट. दिस 0.1 डिवाइड बाई 2 वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट 0.05, ओके, और 5 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 2 और 5 इंटू 10 टू पावर माइनस 2 इंटू डब्ल्यू. फर्दर आई एम सॉल्विंग दिस डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू 200 इंटू 10 टू पावर 6 इंटू 3.14 इंटू डी क्यू डिवाइड बाई 10 टू पावर माइनस 2 इज इक्वल टू दिस साइड मल्टीप्लाई बाई 5. फर्दर 16 वाज देयर, फर्दर वी कैन सॉल्व इट. नो, सो इट मीन्स 10 टू माइनस 2 इज हेयर, सो आई कैन राइट डायरेक्टली 8. एंड हेयर दिस इज 100, दिस इज 8, इफ अप्रोक्सीमेटली टेकिंग दिस इज 20, दिस इज 20, इट मीन्स दिस इक्वेशन विल बिकम 20 इंटू 10 रेज टू पावर 8 इंटू 3.14 डिवाइड बाय 8 डी क्यूब. सो नाउ वी हैव टू बोथ द आइडेंटिफाई द, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द डब्ल्यू एंड डी, वी हैव टू फाइंड द डी ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज योर इक्वेशन 1. वी नो अ के इज इक्वल टू स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट डब्ल्यू बाई डेल्टा एंड योर डब्ल्यू इज के इंटू डेल्टा. के इज योर स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट इज ऑल्सो गिवन टू यू एंड डेल्टा इज गिवन टू यू. वट इज द मैक्सिमम एक्सियल लोड द स्प्रिंग कैन कैरी, मीन्स द डेल्टा इज नॉट गिवन टू यू. सो वी विल पुट W इज इक्वल टू, के क्या गिवन आपको 100 इंटू 10 टू पावर 3 न्यूटन पर मीटर इंटू डेल्टा, इज इट गिवन टू यू. नाउ डेल्टा इज यूर 64 डब्ल्यू आर क्यू एंड डिवाइड बाई सी डी. फर्दर 64 इंटू डब्ल्यू 0.05 रेट पावर 3 इंटू एंड नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स 10 इज गिवन टू यू, सी इज इक्वल टू 100 गीगा न्यूटन इज गिवन टू यू एंड डी की 4. टेक डेल्टा इज इक्वल टू 80 इंटू 10 रेट पावर माइनस 15 एंड डब्ल्यू बाई डी की 4. सो दिस यू विल गेट, यू कैन पुट दिस डेल्टा वैल्यू इन डब्ल्यू इक्वेशन. डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू 100 इंटू 10 रेट पावर 3 इंटू डेल्टा 80 इंटू 10 रेट पावर माइनस 15 एंड डब्ल्यू बाई डी की 4. इज इट क्लियर टू यू? Now here you can identify the d value. How it could be that we double cancel out d key 4 is equal to 8000 into 10 to the power minus 12. Further, I am solving this. When we identify the d value from the calculator, you can see as 1.65 meter or 16.5 mm. So you identified the d here. Now you can put this d value indirectly into this equation, you will identify the w. How it could be? W is equal to 20 into 10 to the power 8 into 3.14 into d. How it could be? D meters, 1.65 raised to the power 2 divided by 8. When I am further solving this equation, 400 into 10 to the power newton. So we identified the w and we identify the d. And d the, we have to find the d the diameter, and diameter of the wire should be a 1.65 meter, and W is calculated here 400 into 10 to the power newton. So this will be your answer. This is your answer, and this diameter is the answer. So in next question, question number 5, you can see a closed coil helical spring is to have a stiffness of the 1000 newton meter. It means a stiffness, a K is given to you, 1000 newton per meter. So a compression with the maximum load of 50 newton, it means a W is given to the 50 newtons, and the maximum shear stress, this is also given to you, 100 newton per mm square. You can see students, your stiffness is given to the newton per meter, and your load in 50 newton, and you are given to the shear stress in mm. So Remember these dimension notations also. The solid length of the spring I coil in touching is 50 mm. So it means your coil length, L length of the coil is given to you, 50 mm. A closed length, it means, I'm plotting here, it means a closed length to given to you. Due to compression, your spring is closely coiled. They don't have any distance in between the two coils. And at here, from top side, W is acting, this is 50 Newton. And you can see, this is a diameter D1. This is diameter, this is also a diameter, this is also a diameter, this is also a diameter, and this is also a diameter. It means this length will become ND. Is it clear? This closed length will become the ND by, because N is the number of turns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and D is the diameter of the wire. It means it can be a mm or it will be a meter. So, the basic fundamental of this question is, I am repeated here. So, this is a case of the compression case of the spring. So, we have to identify a diameter of the wire. We have to identify a diameter of the wire. Second thing, we have to know about the mean diameter of the coil, and we have to find out the number of turns. We have to also find out, and your 50 is given to you. This is not a L length is given in terms of ND, in terms of ND, because why? This is a compression case and the closely coiled spring case is there. So ND is given to you, ND is given to you here, 50 in your question. So is it clear? So your modulus of rigidity C is also given to you at 10 raised to power 5 Newton per mm square. So the all terms are given to you mm square. So we will take this mm square in all this question when we solve this. So let's start with the we have to find first a D, diameter of the wire. How could you find out the diameter of the wire? The wire diameter from the from this formula D, how to be delta is equal to 64 W R cube N divided by the C D four. In terms of delta, we cannot use it directly this formula, because we don't know about the delta, but we know about the stiffness of the spring. It means we know about the K, and K, you know the K? K is load upon delta. So we directly can write, and we have a K value 1000. From this we can find out the delta. How it could be? K is given to you 1000 is equal to W is given to you 50, and this is your delta. At here we take 64 WR cube N divided by the CD4. From this we can identify the D here. How it could be? Put this delta value here. K is equal to W upon 64 WR cube N divided by CD4. Right? W to W cancels out, and K having stiffness 1000, and CD4 C is also given to you 10 to 10 to power 4. And this is 4 given to you in question. Multiply by D4, D have to identify D, and what will be left in denominator? W is cancels out, 64 into R cube. R cube, what is R cube? R cube also you have to find out into N. Right? Your N is also given to you. So in terms of DRN, you identify. You identify D4 is equal to 64 into 10 to power 3. R cube N divided by 10 raised to power 5. So we will use this equation further. So you name this equation 1. So the CHS formula, your tau is given to you 60 WR divided by pi D cube. Here a tau is given to you. How much value is given to you? 100 Newton per mm into is equal to 16 into W. You have to find out R is not given to you, and 3.14 into D cube. From here we can find D cube is equal to 16 WR divided by 3.14 into 100. W is given to you. So, D cube is equal to 16 into 50 into R divided by 3.14 into 100. Now, we can find out in this D and R. So, D cube further will become 314 minus of 800. is equal to r. Sorry, it's not minus. It's not minus. It will be divided by 800. So we'll identify this r. Now, or r could be represented as 0.4 d cube. Now put this r value in this equation one. How it could be? I'm deleting this. I'm writing this r value here. You will find out the r is equal to 0.4 d cube, and we will put this value in this equation, and this will become, I'm deleting here, d cube for 64, that was cancelled out, r cube here, 0.4 d cube and cube further into n number of terms divided by 100. We know now where d and n is given to you. In your question, this is a compression case, your nd is equal to 50 is given to you. It means the nd is equal to 50, or you can say n is equal to 50 by d. So it means the n number of terms, we can put this n value at here. So in terms of d, we will gain 64 into 10 to the power minus 3 into d ki 6 into n kya hoga mera 50 by d divided by 100. I can solve it. This is single d is here. So what terms is going to be decide? 100 divided by 64 into 10 to the power 2 minus 3 to the power. So we can identify d here is equal to 4.7 mm. Similarly, mean radius of the coil. Mean radius of the coil, what will be? R is equal to kya equation I think our time 0.4 d cube. Yeah, I think from this equation when R is equal to 0.4, what are d cube? 4.7 raised to power cube. Further, I am solving this, we will obtain r is equal to 41 mm. Is it clear? Now we have identified the diameter of the wire. This is the diameter of the wire. We identified the number of turns, but we didn't find the number of turns. Number of turns, which should be this n is equal to 50 by d is given, and we identify the d, so we put the d value here. So n is equal to 50 by 4 by 7. It will further, we can solve. It is near to the n is, it will be a some it will greater than 10, because when we solve the denominator is 47, so it will be 10 point something. So for the round figure, it will take a 11. So n is the number of turns in this question will be 11. So in your next question number 6, we are given to you, you can see on your whiteboard, a closed coil helical spring is 100 mm mean and diameter. It means you are given to you the mean diameter of the coil, capital T, is given to you 100 mm, or it could be a 0.1 meters. It is made of 10 mm diameter. Wire diameter is also given to you. Wire dia D is equal to 10 mm, or you can say 0.01 meter rod, and has 20 number of turns. It is 20 number of turns, means number of turns is also given to you, and it is given to you 20. Further, the spring carries an axial load of 200. It means W is also given to you 200 Newton. And determine the shearing stress. Now you have to identify the shearing stress. We have to directly put this formula of the shear stress. You can identify the shear stress in this numerical. So take modulus of rigidity 100 giganewton. A modulus of rigidity C is given to you 100 giganewton per meter square. Determine the deflection. We have to identify also the deflection delta. When the carrying load is also there, and also the calculated stiffness of the spring, we have to identify the K, W by delta. We have to need to find out. It means your K stiffness you have to find out. You have to find out delta. It means pehle aapko delta find out karna padega when you go for the K stiffness. So from the question, you have to identify that the shear stress. The shear stress having formula 16 WR divided by the pi D cube. Is it clear to you? Now put the directly values 16, but load carrying is 200 given to you. R is the mean diameter is given to you, and convert the radius 0.05 divided by pi. D is the diameter of the wire is also given to you, 0.1 raised to power 2. 16 into 2 raised to power 10 raised to power 2 into 5 into 10 raised to power minus 2 divided by 3.14 into 1 into 10 raised to power minus 3. The minus 1 is there, it will be 3, and you further I'm solving. These are the 5, these are 10160. So 16 into 10 raised to power 4 divided by 3.14,
50 into 10 raised to power 6 tau newton per meter square. So you identified the tau shear stress.
in this question you have to further identify that the delta is a deflection. So you know the formula of the deflection. Delta is given to you from the derivation. We identified that 64 WR cube and divided by the CDQ4. It means when we directly equate this all these values, WI here is 200 and the number term C is given to 20, I think. Yes, 20. C is given to you. Mode of the electricity raised to power 9 gigameter was there. Meter square is there and T is the diameter 0.1 raised to power 4. So this is giving you, you can easily identify the delta. You can simplify this further into 2 to the 4 into 10 raised to power cube divided by the 10 raised to power 11 into 1 into 10 raised to power minus 4. Further, I am solving this. Delta is equal to, or you can say 64, 4 power 16.
Here a meter.
We can identify the stiffness K. K is W by delta. You know the K you have to identify. W is given to you and delta is when K is equal to what is your W? W is 200 Newton and delta is given to you in 0.0256. Further, I'm discussing if I'm calculating this K, we will identify the K, or you can say 200 256 into 10 raised to power 4. If I'm taking is a whole figure approximate, I can identify 10 and the 8 and 10 3. So the stiffness here at K 8 into 10 raised to power 3 Newton per meter. So deflection we identified and stiffness we identified, and here a tau stress is also identified. So these are the some numerical students for the based on the closed coil helical spring. So these are all the numericals that is based on the derivation that we discussed in the lecture 2. So students, thank you for the today.